Oh, hey, I didn't see you there. You must be here for 5 Minute Friday. And we are back with another 5 Minute Friday, where we put 5 minutes on the clock to give you one amazing tip to make your gym just a little bit more awesome. I've trained at quite a few big box gyms in my life, and I've got to be honest, I'm not a big fan of the commercial gym environment. There's a lot of big things that I didn't like. Didn't like the music. I didn't like having to work out and wipe other people's sweat off of equipment. I didn't like having to wait for things. I didn't like, and if this is you, shame on you. I didn't like having to find the weights that weren't ever put back where they were supposed to be. And those are the big things, but sometimes it was just the little things that set me off. And today I want to share with you one of those that really just made me dread my trip to the gym. It's these guys. Now, I know it seems simple and I know it seems dumb, but every commercial gym I've ever worked out at had these for collars, these springy, worthless things. You know, the ones that scratch your barbell, the ones that are either too loose and don't stay on or too tight and won't actually go on the end of your barbell. These things are terrible. They're so terrible, in fact, that one of the first things I bought for myself as far as home gym equipment, long before I ever had a home gym, was a nice set of collars. I've been using Lockjaw collars for years and years and years. They're my favorite, and I bought a pair to take back and forth with me to the gym because I just couldn't stand these. So when I built my home gym, somehow I ended up with a pair of these. Now, as worthless as I think these are, I didn't want to throw them out. I knew that at some point I'd find a use for them. And sure enough, I did. So that's today's tip. So I'm going to show you what you can do with these things once you replace them with a set of these. And I'll put a link in the description of these. Look, if you don't have a good set of collars, you owe it to yourself. Pick yourself up a set of Lockjaws. They're so much nicer to use. But for now, let's take a look at what you can actually do with these, and it's not hold your weights on the bar. Any quality barbell that you order is going to come with one of these, a maintenance and care guide. And inside that guide, it's going to recommend that every 3 or 6 or 12 months you do a full maintenance on your bar. And that full maintenance is going to involve laying it down, brushing it off, making sure you get all the junk and dirt and chalk out of the grooves, cleaning it up real nice, and then applying a coat of oil to the bar itself and the bearings, letting it sit overnight so that that cures. And in the end, it's a little bit of a process. And because it's a little bit of a process, a lot of people choose not to do it. So the easier you can make that process, the more likely you are to do it, and the more likely you are to clean your bar like that, the longer your bar is going to last. And believe it or not, this is where those spring collars come in. But let me show you the setup, and this is where these collars come into play. And the first thing we're going to need is some plyo boxes. So let's get those in here. All right, these two from Rep will do the trick. Both the same height, far enough apart to hold the collars. Next thing we're going to need is some towels. There we go. Now, because you're working with oil, you want to put towels down. You don't want oil on your boxes. You don't want oil on the floor. And oh, by the way, I use boxes just because it's easier. You could do this whole process on the floor, but I do like getting them up. And then I can sit on the bench. It's a little bit easier on my back, and it's a little bit just more of an enjoyable process when it's up high. Next, let's get the bar. All right, here we go. Rep stainless steel barbell. Now, these typically don't need a lot of maintenance, but this one will do for this demonstration. And the last thing we need is those spring collars. All right, here they are. So what was useless up till now will have a pretty cool use. What we're going to do is we're going to take one each of the spring collars. And you're going to put them on the bar so that it holds it up and in place. Because one of the things that you'll find when you're trying to maintenance your bar is that A, it'll roll around, and B, because it's either on the ground or even up on these boxes, it's hard to get to the underside or around. And here, I can rotate the bar in place, get all sides of the bar, really brush out the neural pattern if I've got a lot of stuff in there, and then apply a nice even coat of oil, get it all set up. It's all in place. It's all nicely set. This is where I leave it overnight for it to cure, come in, wipe it down the next day, pick up the towels, and you're ready to go. So that's it. Real quick one today for the 5 Minute Friday. Hope you enjoyed it. Hope it makes cleaning your bar a little bit easier. Now, if you like this tip, give me a thumbs up. If you have tips that you want to share with other people out there that you'd like me to make a video on, please post those in the comment. I'd be happy to do so if I think they're going to be helpful to everybody. And that's it for today. Go enjoy your Friday. Until next time, I'm Tim with Gym Crafter.